guys, welcome back. Welcome if you are new. I am KK and this is Colorful Camille. And yeah, today I really wanted to just kind of sit down, do a full face of makeup, kind of like a little get ready with me using some new products that I've purchased recently mixed in with some older ones that I have in my collection already. But majority new stuff that I'm trying. And honestly, I really had a good time and enjoyed most of the products. Now, as you can see, I did do a pretty colorful, bold eye look, which that's nothing new for me. And with it being summertime, you know, approaching summertime, I really like to kind of play with different colors. So today I use this palette, which is from Sample Beauty. This is the Blooming Lovely. And this palette is so colorful. It's so colorful. I definitely could not open up this palette and just do a non-colorful look. Although there are a few little, you know, earth tones scattered in here, very few. For the most part, this palette is extremely colorful. So hence I have these colors on my eyes and hopefully you like them. If you would like to just hang out with me, relax, chill, and watch me do this full face today, because this is a full face of a lot of new products, and kind of hear my first impression thoughts, then stay tuned because it is coming up next. I'm starting out today's look using my Tarte Baba Balm Moisturizer. This moisturizer is very, very thick, very creamy, and it really leaves my skin nicely hydrated. So I really like using this moisturizer. And it soaks into the skin pretty quickly, so it doesn't just sit there on top of your skin. Very nice. Now for my lips, I'm going in with this Pharmacy Lip Smoothie. This stuff is really nice, you guys. I really like it. I picked it up from Sephora. Now for my brows, I'm starting out with the Fenty Beauty Brow Stick. This is actually my favorite brow stick. I'm just using it, as you can see, to lay down the hairs and kind of, you know, make them stay in place before I go in and fill them in a little bit. Now I like to brush them up. I like my brows to go kind of upward. And so that's what I'm doing here. And to fill them in, I'm going in with my NYX pencil. This is just one of their retractable pencils, and I like to just gently fill my brows in. I did have them microbladed about a year and a half ago now, and I'm due for a touch-up, so I like to just kind of gently go in and fill them in. To further clean them up, I'm using my Wet n Wild concealer. This concealer works great for this. It's probably a great concealer overall. I've never used it anywhere else on my face, but I love it for my brows. Okay. Now to prep my lids, I'm using my P. Louise base as usual, just tapping a little bit on this smaller firm brush and tapping it all over my lids. I want to make sure that I have a nice even base for this eye look. Since I am doing bright colors today, I really want it to be nice and smooth. Now, I showed you guys this palette earlier in the video. It's the Blooming Lovely palette from Sample Beauty. Extremely colorful and bright. I'm gonna start out today's look with this light peach shade, and I'm just taking a fluffy brush and applying that in my crease area. Nothing fancy, I just wanna have a nice light shade for my other shadows to blend into. Now I'm going into this beautiful, it's kind of like a orangey rust colored shade, and I'm just tapping that on the inner corner of my eyelid because I really want to have this as one of the prominent colors that you see as part of this eye look. It's very pigmented and it's going down very nice. Next, I'm going into the dark brown shade in this palette and just using a pointed fluffy brush to tap that in the outer corner. And what I wanna do is just kind of blend that into that first shade to kind of bring the inner corner and the outer corner together. So that's what I'm doing here, just kind of dragging it into that crease. Now I really wanted to add a little bit
more of a bright pop of color. So I grabbed this bright purple shade, not knowing that it was going to be that pigmented. So I tapped a little bit off of my brush so I can blend that into that brown a little bit easier. But yeah, it was very, very pigmented, you guys. So I decided to take that first shade, that light peach, and just kind of use that to blend out that purple shade. Now I'm cleaning up this eye look a little bit. I usually get a little messy with my eyelids when I do them first because I know, you know, I can always clean it up. So I wanted to be adventurous. You guys know I like to mix colors up, and I'm going in on my lid with this forest green shimmer. The shimmer was so pretty. It's kind of like a putty texture in the palette, but I'm just taking it on a flat brush and applying that on my lid, and I'm just creating my own like cut crease shape, you know, with that shimmer. Now I'm going back in with that dark brown and just kind of blending out that outer corner, smoking it out so that I can make sure all of these colors kind of combine and don't look super crazy together. Now I'm just going in and applying a little bit of liquid black eyeliner, and I'm just applying it right at the lash line and creating a small wing, nothing too dramatic. I'm going in with these 3D lashes. Now we're moving on to the base, and I am applying my primer. I'm using this Becca primer. Have not used this primer for a very long time. And this is a mattifying primer. I forgot just how mattifying of a primer that this is. You guys, my face felt so dry and so tight when I put this primer on, and it just really made me realize how much I like hydrating primers. I really, really prefer a more moisturizing, hydrating primer now. I'm not into the mattifying anymore. I used to really love mattifying primers when my skin was more oily, but now my skin is pretty normal. I don't really have a lot of issues with oils and, you know, a lot of grease coming out now throughout the day. So yeah, I don't really need a primer this mattifying. So yeah, I don't think I'll be using this again, but it was kind of funny just as I put it on, remembering how drying it was. But it did blur out my pores quite a bit. So to take care of my dark circles and hyperpigmentation today, I decided to try out my Too Faced Born This Way concealer. I typically use my Essence concealer for handling my hyperpigmentation areas, but tried something different today. And honestly, I prefer to use the Essence Camouflage Concealer over this Too Faced. I just like the tone of it, the shade of it better. But there's nothing wrong with this Too Faced concealer. It's actually a really nice concealer. But with the Essence Camo Concealer, it actually has a little bit of peachiness to it. So it does really work as a color corrector for me as well. Now for foundation today, I am trying out this CoverGirl Outlast foundation. This is my first time trying it, and I really love the shade. I have shade 872 Warm Tawny. And with this foundation claims to be extreme wear, light airbrush finish, and it's 24 hours. So yeah, I honestly can see that, okay? Because it definitely has an airbrushing effect. It is long lasting because it did last all day. And I think along with that mattifying primer, it really, really just gave that whole matte airbrushed look where I knew my face was not going anywhere. I was not going to get oily. Nothing was going to move. So I think if you like that type of a finish, these two products work well together. But for me, it was a bit much. So now I'm going in with the Kiss Concealer. I've never used this before either. And I think it's a really good concealer. It really, really is. I feel like I would prefer to try it out with a more hydrating foundation and primer because I think with my face feeling so tight and so dry and so matte that I wasn't really able to appreciate the concealer as much as I would if I had a more hydrated or hydrating foundation on. So I will try it again with one of my other foundations and primers. So yeah, but first impression, I think it is a very nice, affordable concealer, okay? And I'm so glad that I picked it up and I'm able to play with it a little bit more. Now I'm going in and setting these concealed areas with my Beauty Bakery flower powder. Honestly, I feel like I could have just went without any powder. That is how matte my face is right now. I was like, I don't even need any powder, okay? But of course, we always have to powder. So yeah, I'm just using my sponge to lightly powder those concealed areas. And to set the rest of my face, I'm going to be going in with this new lip bar. This is a finishing powder. I've never tried it before. It's in the shade Bronze Beauty. And to apply it, I'm using one of my new Sonia Kashuk brushes. This brush is real nice, you guys. It is very nice. It's a little bit more firm, a little more dense than I'm used to. When applying my powder, I use something a little bit softer, a little bit fluffier. But this one works just fine, quite honestly. I like the size of it. I like the shape of it. And it worked out nicely. So to bronze, I'm using my Gucci bronzer in the shade 5. And I don't know, I guess I kind of forgot that this bronzer is not super duper warming on my skin. I know it's a really nice bronzer, but I think with the foundation I have on today, it's not as warm and bronzing as I remember it being, but it's still a decent bronzer. It just wasn't my favorite for today. So for blush, you guys, let's try out these new L'Oreal blushes. And I'm using another Sonia Kashuk brush. This one is a little bit softer, a little bit fluffier, so more appropriate for blush application. And I really like this blush. It left a nice soft pinky flush on my cheeks. It wasn't super duper pigmented, very buildable, and I like it. I think I really like how it looked with this eye look that I did as well. I think it matched nicely with that crease color. So to kind of add a little hydration, I'm going in with my Morphe setting mist. Y'all, my face felt like it was about to crack. It was so dry. Okay, so now for highlighter, I'm using this new NYX Born to Glow highlighter. I mean, it might not be new, but it's new to me. I had never seen it before. It's gorgeous. Look how pretty, you guys. It is so smooth. It was just so beautiful. I'm very, very happy with this highlighter. Really enjoyed applying it. It just looked really, really nice and just gave my cheeks and my nose a nice, soft, natural glow. So now I'm going to go in and finish up my eye look with some green eyeliner. I just used this forest green eyeliner. I believe it's a ColourPop eyeliner. The writing kind of came off, so I'm not sure. But to further smoke out that lower lash line, I'm going back in the palette and using this super duper dark forest green shadow. It's so pretty. I mean, I knew whatever kind of look I was doing today, I was gonna use this shadow because I love that super dark forest green. And I'm just using a small dense brush to apply that. Now to make it a little bit more smooth and not so harsh, I'm going in with a little bit of that face powder and just kind of brushing that on the edge of that shadow just so that it blends out a little more nicely and it's not super duper harsh right there under my eyes. Now for mascara, I'm going in with this L'Oreal Telescopic Lift. I've been trying this for the past few weeks and I don't really like it. I know, that's just my opinion. Honestly, I feel like it's the applicator that I don't like. I can't say it's the mascara itself because the mascara looks fine, but this applicator, I just can't get with it. I don't like it. I don't like the shape of it, the size of it. I definitely won't be buying this mascara again. Now for lips, I'm going in with my Sephora lip liner in the shade Molasses. I love this lip liner and apparently a lot of other people do because it was sold out when I tried to order some more. But yeah, love this lip liner, really pretty. And I'm trying one of these Maybelline, what is it called? Vinyl ink lipsticks. Y'all, I like this lipstick. It's so comfortable and creamy and smooth. I love it. I love it, love it, love it. It did not dry out my lips and it just looks so pretty to me. So this is it, you guys. This is the final look for today. I hope you like it. I really like it. I don't like the fact that my face feels so dry, but I do like the airbrush appearance of everything. So let me know down in the comments what you think about the palette, about the foundation, about the powders, and you know, we can have a conversation about it. Thanks so much for watching, you guys. Don't forget to hit like, subscribe, leave me a comment, and I'll see you on the next one. Toodles!